It's AumSum time!
Why do bubbles pop?
'Cause they like to make pop music.
Nah.
Huh?
A bubble is basically a pocket of air surrounded by a thin, tenuous layer of soapy water. This thin layer can be of just water too, but such bubbles don't float. Now, bubbles form because of a special property of water molecules to attract and stick to each other. These attractive forces between water molecules produce what's called surface tension. This surface tension, along with the air pressure from inside and outside the bubble, create a fragile equilibrium and keep the bubble from popping. However, since the equilibrium is fragile, just a gust of wind or our dry finger easily breaks the surface tension, thus breaking the tenuous layer and causing the bubble to pop. Besides this, dry air also causes the water to evaporate from the tenuous layer. Hence, it gradually gets thinner and thinner, and eventually, the bubble pops. Why honey doesn't spoil?
'Cause honey is actually a magical potion.
Nah.
Honey doesn't spoil mainly because of osmosis. Osmosis is the movement of water from a region of higher water concentration through a semi-permeable membrane to a region of lower water concentration. Now, the water content in honey is far less than the water content in organisms like bacteria and fungi. Hence, when such organisms try to enter honey, the water from their bodies moves out into the honey due to osmosis. As a result, they die, and thus, the honey doesn't spoil. In addition to this, some bees produce antibiotics within their bodies to protect themselves against certain bacteria. However, when bees make honey, some of these antibiotics get added to the honey. These antibiotics also prevent the growth of bacteria, thus preventing the honey from spoiling.
Why do we have different skin colors?
It is because of a pigment called melanin and ultraviolet radiation of the sun. Confused?
Obviously.
Alright, I'll explain. Millions of years ago, people living near equator received a lot of sunlight and ultraviolet radiation. Now, ultraviolet radiation is actually absorbed by our skin to produce vitamin D. But excess radiation can damage our skin cells. Hence, the skin of these people produce more melanin to block the excess ultraviolet radiation. Thus, over time, these people and their succeeding generations adapted to have a higher level of melanin in their skin, making their skin darker. However, people living away from equator receive less sunlight and less ultraviolet radiation. Hence, in order to absorb sufficient ultraviolet radiation and produce the essential vitamin D, these people and their following generations adapted to have a lower level of melanin, thus making their skin lighter. Why shouldn't we look at the sun?
We shouldn't look at the sun because the moon will feel jealous!
No! It is because the sun not only gives out a tremendous amount of light, but it also emits ultraviolet radiation. This radiation can harm our eyes and even make us blind.
Nah, I don't believe you.
Alright, I'll explain. When we look or stare at the sun for a long time, the emitted ultraviolet radiation burns the outermost layer of our eyes called cornea, causing intense pain and inflammation. This condition is called photokeratitis. In addition to this, the radiation also damages the proteins present in the eye lens, giving us cataract and thus causing blurry vision. Moreover, the ultraviolet radiation even damages the light-sensitive cells in the retina, which help us to see. This condition is called solar retinopathy. Solar retinopathy can lead to temporary or even permanent blindness.